Coming to activity 3, for this you have to take a conical flask. So that is like this shape. You take a conical flask like a cone shape. So in this conical flask, you take a few granules of zinc. So you take a few granules of zinc, you take it in the conical flask and add dilute hydrochloric acid. We have the solutions are of two types, dilute and concentrated. Okay, now in this, to the zinc granules, you must add dilute hydrochloric acid. So pour through the thistle funnel and just you add hydrochloric acid. Here, what are the substances we are taken? Zinc plus dilute hydrochloric acid. When you add these two, just you wait few minutes and observe what reaction is taking place. When you observe after few seconds, then some gases are evolving from the conical flask. So when the gases are evolving, at that condition, you bring one burning matchstick. And bring nearer and place it nearer the where is the gas is evolving. Just you should not keep it attached with this flask. Just place it nearer the conical flask. Then immediately that burning matchstick is put off the flame. When you place the burning matchstick near the neck of the conical flask where the gases are releasing, then immediately reaction takes place and the burning matchstick will put off the flame. Means here, when you are taking the zinc granules and when they are reacting with the hydrochloric acid, here some gases are evolving. Here, which gas it put off the flame? That is hydrogen. Oxygen gas is always help to burn. So here to put off the flame, it is hydrogen gas. So here hydrogen gas is evolved. So this is one more activity. Now, in all these activity 1, activity 2 and activity 3, these are all the examples of chemical changes. In this chemical changes, chemical reactions are taking place. So, in all the chemical reactions, always we are getting the new substances. The first one is, always we are getting the new substances. When you are taking calcium oxide and water, you are not getting again calcium oxide and water. You are getting the new substance that is known as calcium hydroxide. Along with that, some amount of heat is liberated and some reactions heat is absorbed. At that time, when you touch the test tube or the beaker, you feel that it is cool. When it is cool, heat is absorbed. When you touch it, if it is hot, heat is liberated after the chemical reaction. Now coming to activity 2, in this also, when you are taking the colorless solutions, you are getting the new substance and the precipitate is forming. Now coming to the activity 3, in that when you are taking this zinc and hydrochloric acid, gases are evolving. So from all these three examples, when a chemical reaction taken place, how to identify? By knowing always new substances are forming, precipitations are forming and gases are evolving and the temperature, sometimes heat is liberated and sometimes heat is absorbed. So like that we can identify that there is a chemical reaction taking place. Now coming to here, in all these activities, reactions, I wrote it in the sentence formation. So, for any activity, for any chemical reaction, to write it in the word or sentence formation, always time waste. And it is a lengthy process. when calcium oxide something something react like this, if you write it, time waste and it is a lengthy process. So to make it in the short form and in a simple form, we have to write all these chemical reactions by representing with the symbols of that particular compounds. That we will call it as chemical equations. When you represent the chemical reaction, when you represent in a symbolic form, that reaction is known as chemical equation. Now our lesson 2 is chemical equations. We'll discuss more about chemical equations, how to balance. Based on that, we have to do problems, we have to solve the problem. That all we'll learn from chemical equations. So what is our lesson 2? Chemical What is our lesson 2 name? Chemical equations. Once again, when a chemical reaction is taking place, always new substances are forming, precipitates are forming, gases are evolving, and at the same time, temperature either it is released or temperature is heat is released or heat is absorbed. Right.